standing here in the timber, and this is what I grew up hunting. I'll be honest with you, it's not my cup of tea now. Being in the Midwest where it's ag rich, I like to hunt edge and I like to hunt food. But what I've learned over time is you can manipulate the timber just as much as anything else. We talk a lot about food plot structure and having a boomerang shape and where to put a Banks blind or where to hang a tree stand. You can do the same thing in the timber, but the first thing you have to do is pick out the highest and best use tree-wise. Pick out the stand you need to be in for the best wind, best access, best terrain, anything you can think of. Pick that tree out and then go backwards from there. If you come into an area and you go, oh, I really like this area, I'll just be in that tree, and you start cutting stuff, it may not work out to your advantage. It may be a big disadvantage. You can come in here and girdle trees. You can do some TSI. You can fall some stuff just in the way as a block. But if that's not all centered around the tree first, then you're kind of working backwards. So literally, you kind of do have to work backwards. Start at the end point where, hey, I'm going to sit in this stand, and this is what I want to take place right here. And then manipulate everything to that result. So that's what you're doing. You're chasing a result, not chasing the work. Because if you do it the other way, the work could chase you. So just make sure you pick out the tree, best access, best wind, approach, exit, funnel, terrain, all that that's already there and its highest and best use, and then manipulate it from there, whether it's girdling trees, moving treetops. A lot of times I'll hunt a stand and I'm like, man, something's not right here. You get down on the way out in the broad daylight after you walked in the dark, whatever the case may be, and there's a tree fell. Well, that tree literally cut off that ridge. The deer work around it and go a different way. So obviously if that happens, man-made, you can do the same thing to keep the deer in there. So just some things to think about when you're hunting in the timber. It applies to the food plots. It applies to anything like that. Make it work to your advantage, but start at the end and work your way back. One of the things I often hear, and I did it myself a lot, is, oh, I like the way that spot looks. I used to walk into a timber spot where I basically learned to hunt on my uncle's farm. And I'd walk in there and go, oh, this looks cool. And really, I had no idea, to be honest with you. It was generally a more open area. This farm was pretty woolly. Had the timber cut on it, held a lot of deer, but I took into consideration nothing else. I mean, if I could see 100 yards, 150 yards, I thought that was a good spot. And really had nothing to base it on. Over time, I realized, well, when I seen the deer over here and I seen the deer do this, or over watching the deer, I realized that the terrain made them do that. A funnel made them do that. A drop off, whatever the case may be. So when you're in the timber, it's not as easy. Food plot, it's a destination. Everything's coming there. It eats, it leaves, it comes in and out. There's entrances and exits. The sign is prevalent. In the timber like this, especially this year before it was cut, it was hard to see stuff in here. There was two faint rub lines coming up through these draws. And I picked up on those, seen a few scrapes here and there in late October. And it really, everything kind of centered to this. This timber top right here, this ridge. So when you're in the timber, the sign may not look incredible, but open your eyes, for lack of a better word, look around. It's the subtle things in the timber that add up. Don't just walk into an area because it's A, close, B, it's open, C, you just like the look of it, or it's pretty. I mean, if that's what you want to hunt, that's great. But there's more to it when it comes to killing a bigger deer or seeing a bigger deer even. Pay attention to your terrain. Pick up on the smaller sign, whether that's deer scat, one rub here, one scrape there. And I also do a lot of orbits in the timber. I'll find something, and if I don't see anything take off from it, I'll kind of make a circle around it and another circle around it. And generally, you'll find the next scrape or the next rub, and you can kind of put a line together that way. And you look down at it and go, well, I can see that now. He's kind of working this side hill. That's where you need to be, not over here, over there, just because it's pretty, or you can see a lot, or whatever the case may be. Try to grind down on that just a little more. It's faint sign often. Now in some areas, it's beat to death. Obviously, if it's 200 yards from a food plot, it's going to be more prevalent. But we're a long ways from food here. Our closest food plot doesn't exist yet. We're going to build it. The neighbor has a field right here that's fallow. And then the other side is cattle pasture. So there's no food right here. Deer don't spend a lot of time here. The sign is gonna be faint until we get it brushed in and get the habitat better to where this is a bedroom. Then obviously when it's a bedroom, the sign will be more prevalent. There'll be beds everywhere. There'll be scrapes, there'll be rubs, everything of that nature. But if you walk into a fresh piece of timber, it can be intimidating to a lot of guys, and still is to me. It's not my cup of tea. Like I said, I prefer to hunt field edges and food plots. But a lot of the best farms we sell are all timber small tracts that happen to be a connector in between ag fields or bigger farms or whatever the case may be. So don't be afraid of it. When you get in there, if you see small sign, like I said, generally do kind of an orbit or a walk around that and try to put the next small sign together. And I bet if you look back at those, they kind of make a line, a direction, or they have a rhythm to them, if you will, and try to follow that and hunt off of that instead of just walking in and picking something.